किसको पता था दैट देयर वुड कम अ टाइम व्हेन मीम्स वुड बी सोल्ड एट $4 मिलियन, ट्वीट्स वुड फेच 7 फिगर बिड्स, और हमें घर पे बैठना पड़ेगा फॉर मोर देन अ ईयर? लेट मी रिमाइंड यू गाइस, 2021 चल रहा है, वी हैव सीन इट ऑल, बट कुछ भी हो सकता है. Well, all we do is sit at home.
Dalgona Coffee का तो नाम सुना ही होगा आपने.
No, no. Not that.
Corona, go! Corona, go! Oh, Corona, go!
Not that. Definitely not that. अरे कौन डाल रहा है ये सब? Editor, why am I even paying you? Well, jokes aside, this is about none of that. It is about a tiny nation named El Salvador in Central America, where a Twitter idea made it to the state policy. What? Well, long story short, Nick Carter, who is a Bitcoin enthusiast, regularly hosts these audio chats on a platform known as Twitter Spaces. For those of you who have not given into the Clubhouse frenzy yet, how are you doing it, first of all?
Don't question it, just do it.
Also, if you have an invite, then follow me. And for those of you who did not get an invite yet, audio chat is like a con call with people across the world, where you can discuss about varied topics like health, infrastructure, medicine, dating, I don't know, so many varied topics, anything you want to talk about. And of all the stories that you might have heard in which people got bored and then did something interesting, this is the prime, the award-winning story that there can be.
This man speaks nonsense.
So that day, Nick Carter was getting bored. God bless him. So he got onto Twitter Spaces and they started discussing about the recent bill which would make Bitcoin a legal tender in El Salvador. And mind you, this bill was being voted upon simultaneously in their assembly. Now, somewhere along the middle of this conversation, the young laser-eyed president of El Salvador, Nayib Bukele, joined in as well and started explaining the various reasons of why this bill was being tabled. And let's take a moment right here. How cool is that, and how often does that happen? And by this time, the participants in the conversation ran into thousands, which is when one of the speakers asked President Bukele if they were considering to mine Bitcoin using the geothermal energy harnessed by the many volcanoes present in El Salvador. To which he responded positively, saying that they had not considered it yet, but it seems like a great idea. So that was about the audio chat, which ended on a high, by the way, with the historic bill getting passed. And it took internet by the storm. Everyone seemed to be talking about it.
Duh.
And if it wasn't enough, the next day, President Bukele tweeted this. This story has no end, and literally a Twitter idea went from being just a Twitter idea to a state policy. So we'll analyze this once in a blue moon kind of story and some of the recent developments that happened in El Salvador in our next segment. Welcome you guys to the next segment. It is everything same as the first part of the video, but it just seemed very fancy to me, so I put it.
This man speaks nonsense.
So El Salvador is a small country in Central America which began using dollar as its currency since its own currency became highly volatile. Now dollar provided for the much needed stability, but it has a downside to it as well. One of them is your economy then gets linked to the policies that are set by the RBI of USA or the Federal Reserve. And right now, the Federal Reserve is trying to increase the dollar supply massively, which would have inflationary effects on the countries that use dollar as a currency. So as it turns out, offering Bitcoin as a competitive currency is not to remain in the trends, rather a protectionary move.
Oh, now I see. Now I get it.
Bitcoin is decentralized, and hence no central bank or authority has any control over it. And this is just one of the many advantages that Bitcoin has. If adopted by the people of El Salvador, Bitcoin has the ability to enable greater financial inclusion, cut down the fees on remittances that are lost to the intermediaries, and bring in talent and innovators from across the world, eventually trying to bring people out of poverty in El Salvador. So B2C has the ability of transforming. Not that kind of transformation I was talking about. Who is putting in all these memes, yeah? Editor. Not paying this guy anymore. But I was talking about the transformation of El Salvador's economy if Bitcoin is adopted by its people. And right now, El Salvador might be the smallest country in North America, but this move could make it the most important monetarily. Now, a logical question arises that if there are so many pros to using Bitcoin, adopting Bitcoin, then why not every other country follow suit and adopts Bitcoin or any other cryptocurrency for that matter? Well, the simple answer here is it's not that simple. The cryptocurrency market is still in its nascent stages and is volatile. So is Bitcoin, with some people losing their entire investments in a day. Well, so this is an experiment by El Salvador that also suits it because more or less it has nothing to lose. And as far as popular opinion goes, the people there are fed up of the Fed and also of the gang wars that have negatively affected its economy for decades. So El Salvador is basically following the PayPal's principle of adapting to the newer cryptocurrencies while keeping the ones that they are used to. And for this, they are setting up a development fund which would have $150 million worth of dollars. This is for easy convertibility between dollar and Bitcoin. For instance, if there is an ice cream vendor who gets Bitcoin in return of selling his ice cream, well, that would happen one day in El Salvador. So when he gets that and he does not want to keep the Bitcoin, he can directly approach the development fund to convert it into dollars and keep it. And as far as the concerns of money laundering go, President Bukele is of the opinion that right now the drug cartels operate using the US dollars for their business. But that doesn't mean that you blame the US dollars for it. You blame the criminals for it. And you need to look at the cryptocurrencies in the same way. Also, you don't tell that man no shit on how to govern his own country. Well, the second major concern of adopting cryptocurrencies like Bitcoin is the environmental impact associated with mining. Now, mining is a process which uses powerful computers to support the blockchain network on which the cryptocurrency like Bitcoin is based. And this process uses a lot of electricity, which is generated via using non-renewable sources of energy like crude oil. And the only way out here is to use renewable sources of energy like geothermal energy. So it turns out that the Twitter idea was after all brilliant. Well, what now? Well, we wait. We wait to see how these series of events turn out. But no denying that these series of events were hands down historic. Well, but the question remains, when are you moving to El Salvador, huh? Well, comment that in the comment section below, like this video, spread the word, send it to as many people as you can, subscribe to this channel if you haven't already, it will mean a lot to me. Well, this is it from my side and until next time, bye. Bye.